Hello, my wonderful and amiable listeners. Welcome to yet another interesting news. The former president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, in person of President Muhammadu Buhari, has said that himself and his family are shocked over the ongoing crisis going on in Niger Republic. The former Nigerian president, Muhammadu Buhari, has stated that he and his family have shocked over the latest turn of events in Niger Republic, which has seen the overthrow of the country president, Muhammadu Buhari. The Republic of Niger came into the news on Wednesday as military juntas blocked the country presidential palace and seized power from President Buhari. Muhammadu Buhari, and in the twilight of his administration, boasted about how he would run to Niger Republic to have his peace should he be disturbed by Nigerians in Daura in Katsina State. Reacting to the coup, Muhammadu Buhari on Twitter on Friday wrote, "As to be expected, I, like millions of other Nigerians, am shocked by the latest turn of events in Niger Republic. Concerns have been raised about the fate of democracy as a system of government in the country and in the wider sub-region, and equally so about the safety of President Muhammadu Buhari and his family. I and my family are as much concerned about this as is everyone else. It is disheartening to note that the ECOWAS, under the leadership of President Ashewaju Bola Ahmed Tinubu, is already dealing effectively with the matter, and our hope and prayers are that the unwanted situation will be completely reversed and the safety and well-being of President Buhari and his family should be ensured." It was reported on Friday that the United States of America Vice President Kamala Harris spoke to President Ashewaju Bola Ahmed Tinubu to discuss how to defend West African and Sahel democracy. Harris, who confirmed the call on her Twitter handle on Friday, said she also discussed ties between Nigerian and Americans, shared work on global and regional issues, and how to promote digital inclusion and economic growth. Harris said that, "Today I spoke with the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, in person of Ashewaju Bola Ahmed Tinubu, about the strong ties between the Nigerian and the American people on our shared work on global and regional issues. From defending democracy in West Africa and the Sahel to promoting digital inclusion and economic growth." The President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, Ashewaju Bola Ahmed Tinubu, who is currently the chairman of the Economic Community of West African States, ECOWAS, the United States and many other countries across the world have condemned the Niger coup, while there have been expressions of fear and the successful coup in Niger could expand to the Islamic extreme and Wagner in West Africa. It was reported that on the 26th of July 2023, a coup d'etat occurred in Niger, in which Niger Presidential Guard detained President Muhammadu Buhari, and Presidential Guard Commander General Tsiani proclaimed himself as the leader of the new military junta. Presidential Guard forces closed the country border and suspended state institutions and declared a curfew. Early on the 26th of July, the Nigerian presidency Twitter account announced that Presidential Guard commanded by General Tsiani engaged in an anti-Republican demonstration and tried in vain to obtain the support of the other security forces. It also said that the President Muhammadu Buhari and his family were well after a report emerged that he was being held in the presidential palace in the capital, Niamey. Interior Minister Ahmad Sole was also arrested and held in the palace, while roughly 20 members of the Presidential Guard were spotted outside later in the day. The coup was reportedly led by Tsiani, whom analysts said Buhari had planned to relieve from his position. Sources close to Buhari said that he had decided on Tsiani's dismissal at a cabinet meeting on the 24th of July, as their relations had reportedly become strained. President Buhari's wife, Adiza Buhari, and his son, Salem, were detained with him at the presidential palace, while his daughters were in Paris at the time of the coup. In the morning, the palace and adjacent ministries were blocked off by military vehicles, and palace staff were prevented from accessing their offices. Up to 400 civilian supporters of Bazal tried to approach the palace, but were dispersed by the presidential gunfire, with the presidential guard with gunfire, leaving one injured. Elsewhere in Niamey, the situation was described as calm. The presidency also claimed that protests in support of Bazal had occurred around the country overseeing diplomatic mission. In response to this event, Niger armed forces surrounded the presidential palace in support of Bazal. The army also issued a statement saying that they had secured major strategic points in the country. The presidency stated that the army and the National Guard were ready to attack the presidential guard. The BBC also reported that loyalist forces had surrounded the state broadcaster, ORTN. The United States Embassy warned against travel along Niamey Bola, the Republic, where the presidential palace was located. In the evening, however, Air Force Colonel Major Abdramain went on state television channel Tele Sahel to claim that President Bazal had been removed from the power and announced the formation of the National Council for the Safeguard of the Homeland. Seated and flanked by 9 other officers wearing uniforms representing all the different branches of the security forces, Abdramain said that defense and security forces had decided to topple the regime due to the deteriorating security situation and bad governance. He also announced the dissolution of the country's constitution, the suspension of state institutions, the closure of country's borders, and a nationwide curfew from 2200 hours until 500 local time until further notice, while warning against any foreign intervention. One of the officers seen during the announcement was later identified as General Salau Bamau, the head of the country's special forces. On the morning of the 27th of July, Bazal tweeted that Nigerians who love democracy would see to it that hard-won gains will be safeguarded, indicating that his refusal to step down from office. His foreign minister, Maza Udao, told France 24 that the country's legal and legitimate power remained with the president and reiterated that Bazal was in good condition and that the entire army was not involved. Maza Udao also declared himself acting head of state and called on all Democrats to make this adventure fail. Despite being detained, Bazal had not formally resigned as of the 26th of July and had been able to get in contact with world leaders and officials such as the French President Emmanuel Macron, United Nations Secretary General Antonio Guterres, African Union Commissioner Massoud Faki, and United States Secretary of State Antony Blinken. That will be all for now. Please don't forget to click on the like and subscribe button. And let us know your thoughts and your opinion via the comment section below. And I'll see you on the next news. Bye for now.